Welcome back to D-Max Man Gaming. I'm your host, The Mass Gamer. And here we believe gaming is a lifestyle, not a hobby. Welcome back, guys. And I just want to say a shout out to the gaming community that watch my content. I appreciate you guys leaving a lot of comments. I appreciate the new subscribers. New subscribers, welcome to the community. Welcome to being a gamer that lives the gaming lifestyle. Appreciate you guys. Continue watching, continue supporting the channel. I really appreciate it. This is why I do this for you guys. On to today's topic. Today's topic is Sony. Yes, I've been MIA for a while doing some things for myself. And I came back and a lot of people in the gaming community, a lot of people I know in the gaming community, been DMing me and posting messages on Reddit about how PlayStation now has a new update and now Sony is allowing crossplay. So let's address crossplay first. We all knew Sony was going to do crossplay sooner or later because they was getting a lot of heat from the gaming community. I mean, a lot of heat. And then some of the devs from the gaming industry was coming at Sony about this because everybody else is doing crossplay. If Nintendo can do crossplay, Sony, you can too. And the reason why they decided to finally do it is because, one, they know that they're coming out with a new console in a couple years, and if they didn't allow crossplay, that they weren't going to get the same type of response they got for the PlayStation 4 when they released their new console. That was number one. Number two was a lot of devs talking about, well, we are making games for all platforms and multiplayer games that are non-linear games. We want to have PlayStation 4 fans play with every type of fan. Nintendo fans, Xbox fans, PC fans. This is something that's happened in the game industry and Sony needs to get with it. So Sony finally made a decision to allow crossplay. Congratulations, Sony, for making a great business decision, for saving your asses, because if you wasn't, you was going to feel the wrath of the gaming community. And that's why, even though they gave some silly-ass excuse on why it took them so long, we all know the reason why. They didn't want to do it, but we forced their hand, and now they're allowing crossplay. Good decision, Sony. Congratulations. But today's topic is about Sony's service, PlayStation Now. Yes, I've been hearing some shit about PlayStation Now that's kind of got me going like, okay, what's so special about that? PlayStation Now is allowing you to download PlayStation 4 games or PlayStation 2 games to your hardware when you are subscribed to PlayStation Now for $20 a month. Everyone's shouting this to the heavens. Everyone I know that are big fans of the PlayStation, fanboys are shouting it. You can download PlayStation 4 games from the PlayStation Now library and PlayStation 2 games from the PlayStation Now library. They are now a viable competitor to the Xbox Pass. And I'm going like, oh my God, are you guys not getting enough sleep? Are you taking too much medication? That's absurd. It's absurd. And there's several reasons why this is absurd. And that's, we're going to go over these several reasons why this is absurd in this video today. Because the PlayStation Now will never be a viable competitor to the Xbox Pass. I don't care that the PlayStation Now library has 650 games. They're still missing some key elements that fans want that they are not allowed to give them because they just can't do it. First of all, they only allow you to play PlayStation 4 games and PlayStation 2 games without being online. So you only can download some PlayStation 4 games and some PlayStation 2 games, which I'm sure they're going to add more to the library in the coming years. But you won't be able to download PlayStation 3 games and play without being online. Why? Because the hardware is not backwards compatible to PlayStation 3 games. You're not going to be able to download PlayStation 3 games from the server to your hardware to play them. You're just not. The hardware's not in there. Now, a lot of people are speculating that they're going to do that for the next console that comes out, and they should. That way, they can have a heads up on being able to play all their games on one console like Microsoft, because that's important. Everyone's taking their cue from Microsoft. Microsoft is being very innovative. They're being very driven, and they're going in the right path, and a lot of companies are trying to follow suit, and Sony's going to do it, I guarantee you. You hear right now from the Mass Gamer, the next generation of consoles that they're going to release from Sony will allow you to play PlayStation 4 games, PlayStation 3 games, PlayStation 2 games, and whatever the games they're going to name the new console, all on one hardware. I'm telling you, it's coming, because that's the future. Sony is going to do that. But right now, Sony cannot do that. They're unable to do that, because if they made another upgrade console that allowed that, they would alienate a lot of the fans that already own the PlayStation 4 and PlayStation 4 Pro. That would piss off the customer base, piss off the fan base, and Sony would be in a lot of trouble. So they can't do that. That's something they're not going to do. Let's get that straight. So, like I said before, PlayStation Now would not be a viable competitor to the Xbox Pass for that one reason alone. What's the second reason? Well, the second reason is because Xbox Pass is much cheaper than the PlayStation Now. It's $10. $10 for 100 games. While the PlayStation Now has 650 games. And I'm going to say, well, Mass Gamer, I'd rather have 600 games for $20 a month than 100 games for only $10. That's stupid to me. I want more games to play. Yeah, but what if you live in a rural area? What if you have data caps on your internet where you can't use, you only can use a certain amount of internet without going over your bill? What are you doing then if you have a PlayStation Now and you always have to be online to play the PlayStation 3 games and probably some of the PlayStation 4 games and 2 games because they haven't switched where you can download it yet? You only can right now download certain PlayStation 2 games and certain PlayStation 4 games. So what are you going to do about data caps? What are you going to do about being in a rural area and you got terrible Wi-Fi? Huh? What are you going to do about that? While the Xbox Pass, you download it one time and boom, it's on your hardware. You'll never have to do it again. So if you just download one game once a month to your hardware to play, you're good. If you have a data cap on your internet or if you live in a rural area, you can't do that with the PlayStation Now. Regardless, if you have some games you can download for PlayStation 2 and PlayStation 2, you won't be able to download PlayStation 3 games from what I told you earlier. So you're shit out of luck. So like I said before, they're dreaming if they think it's a viable competitor to the Xbox Pass. It's not. It would never be. And on top of that, on top of all that, did you know with the Xbox Pass you get 10% off the games that are in the library? Yeah, 10% off. And if you are subscribed to Xbox Live, you get another 10% off. And if that game that's in the library on sale, you probably get another 10%. So you can probably get 30% off a game that you've been playing in the library for Xbox Pass, and you get probably 10 to 30% off, and it's even cheaper than ever. Come on. Do you hear what I'm saying? Yeah, we hear you, Mass Gamer. It's much cheaper. You have a lot more options, and it doesn't require you to have a lot of internet to play and use the service. Yes, it doesn't. While PlayStation Now does. And then on top of all that, yes, we all know Microsoft don't have a lot of exclusives, but the exclusives they do have, on release date, on the date that's released into stores, you can download it and play it on the Xbox with the Xbox Pass. Right now, people are playing Forza Horizon 4 on the Xbox right now for $10 a month. Sony's not going to do that. Sony's not going to release their new exclusives to the PlayStation Now. They would lose so much money like that. They would never do that. So that's another reason why the Xbox Pass is beating PlayStation Now. It's a superior service. I know what you guys want to say. I can hear it in the comment section. You're being biased. You're an Xbox fanboy. No, I'm not. I own an Xbox and I own a PlayStation. I'm not biased at all. I'm being very transparent. I'm being honest and giving you my honest opinion. And I'm just laying out the facts. I have travel services. Both services are cool. I have good Wi-Fi. I have no data caps on my Wi-Fi. So I can play the PlayStation Now service without any interference because I got good Wi-Fi. And I can also play the Xbox Pass. Play with the Xbox Pass because I can download any game I want. Because I got good Wi-Fi, so it don't take a lot for me to download 2 or 3 games from the library, from the Xbox Pass, to my console and play it anytime I want for $10. It's just, I just can do both. And like I said before, I have travel services, and the Xbox Pass is much superior to the PlayStation Now. It just is. The service is much better. You have more whistles and bells than you have the PlayStation Now. And that's just a fact. But I let me know your guys' thought in the comment section below. I gave you some really big reasons why PlayStation Now service will never be a viable competitor to the Xbox Pass service. Never, ever. Not in this generation. Let me know what you guys think in the comment section below. And as always, thank you for staying to the end of the video. I appreciate you. Make sure you hit that like button. Helps out the channel a lot. Make sure you share it. That helps out just as much. And if you want to hear more from your boy, the Mass Gamer, make sure you hit that subscribe button and notification bell to be notified when I upload more videos like that. As always, stay safe, keep gaming. You've been watching D-Max Man Gaming. I'm out. Talk to you guys later.